All right, what do you got?
I'm going to say it's 1-1.
All right. How would you figure that out?
Well, first I'd ask you if that's correct.
We'll see when you try to figure it out.
Okay, so the idea here is I'm trying to figure out what Curly would get if Smoove was out to get make certain that Curly got the worst possible value. So Curly gets to choose among rows, and Smoove gets to choose among columns. So if I chose the B column, then Curly could get a 1. You know, given a choice, Curly would go for the first row instead of the second row because Curly would get a 1. If I took the S column as Smoove, Smoove took the S column, then Curly would choose the second row and would get 2. And 1 is lower than 2, so Smoove would choose the first column and Curly would have to get the first row and it would end up in a 1. Does that make sense?
Yes, but here's what you haven't figured out.
Yes.
What happens if Smoove, because if Smoove says, I'm always going to choose the Backstreet Boys,
mm-hmm.
then you're right, Curly should also choose that and at least coordinate.
Mm-hmm.
But what if Smoove is random, say half and half random between the two options?
And I don't know what's going to happen before then?
And you don't know what's going to happen, sorry?
I know it's half, Curly knows it's half and half, but doesn't know which one he's choosing at any given time?
Exactly.
I see. Then I would end up with 1/2 and 1.
Then for choosing B, the expected score would be a half, and for choosing S, the expected score would be 1.
Yep.
Oh, I see. And then Curly would choose S and get the 1.
Right.
And that's still consistent with that.
Mm-hmm.
Can we work out what the worst case is?
What do you mean?
Well, I feel like we should solve it like a zero-sum game, like we did in your lesson.
Oh.
Say that Smoove is actually choosing a probability, either X or 1 minus X.
So I thought you were asking for like a pure decision. I wasn't even thinking about mixed decisions.
Ah, yes. It could be a malicious and randomized adversary.
Ugh. So we really are.
You said ugh.
Well, we really are talking about my ex-girlfriends. Okay, so you just do the math. Do the math.
All right. So if Smoove chooses Backstreet Boys with probability X and Sting with probability 1 minus X, then Curly, for choosing Backstreet Boys, will get X on average, and for choosing Sting, will get 2 times 1 minus X on average. And the useful point is going to be to discover when these are equal to each other.
Yep.
So, in fact, Smoove, by being malicious and stochastic, can actually force things down to 2/3.
Mm.
And things being symmetric as they are, Curly can do the same.
Okay.
So basically, Curly can behave in such a way that even against a malicious adversary, he could guarantee himself a score of 2/3.
Yeah, a malicious, possibly mixed adversary.
That's right.
Okay. But 1-1 would be right if we were sticking with pure strategies. But why would we do that?
That's right. But for the purpose, that's right. And you can do a version of the folk theorem. In fact, there's lots of different flavors of the folk theorem. The one that we're going to focus on is going to allow for these mixed strategies.
Mm-hmm.
But in fact, in general, you could say, no, I kind of like the mixed strategies. Let's just stick with that.
No, I like the mixed strategies too. I just wasn't thinking about them.
So I want to point out that, in fact, the solution that you gave, I think that actually does correspond to what is usually called min-max, which is the pure strategy.
Yay!
So the min-max is in fact 1-1. The other concept is really important too, though, and I think it's sometimes called the security level profile. So instead of the min-max profile, the security level profile. And that allows for the possibility of mixed strategies. So that gets you down to the 2/3, 2/3. I think, it turns out that there's folk theorems that can be defined with either of those concepts. I prefer this one, but I do like this name better. So I apologize if that made things confusing.
I'm not confused now. I think in the end, Michael, the important thing is we were both right.
Well, the example that I'm going to next, these two concepts line up. So let's do that, and then we don't have to care.
I'm all for that. Let's do that.